Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Charles. I want to welcome you guys to the Dreamerspro Podcast. Now, essentially, this is an episode I had no intention of shooting, but I'm just going to shoot it for you guys. But before we get into the content, I want you guys to go ahead and hit the like button and hit the subscribe button. We're trying to get to 10,000 subscribers as soon as possible and hit the notification bell to be notified whenever we drop our content. And the topic today is simple. I'm just going to be doing one topic for you guys, so it won't be too long. It's just going to be reacting to Colin Cowherd ranking Kawhi Leonard at the top 10, being the top 10 greatest players, or in his case, top 5 greatest players in NBA history, if he were to be able to win this NBA championship. So for those of you guys who don't know, Colin Cowherd is an American TV media personality. He used to work with ESPN. Now he's on Fox Sports. He's there. He's 56 years old, but he seems to be in good shape. And he's one of the biggest personalities on that network. And he has his show. He brings a lot of guests, and they talk about a range of different topics. He's had some wacky takes in the past. I generally don't watch Colin Cowherd because I don't really think he knows basketball as well as he thinks he does, especially with some of his takes that he's made. I remember one season he ranked Ben Simmons, I think, in the top 5 or the second best player in the NBA because he said he's just like LeBron James. He can pass, defend, and all this. And the only thing is he can't shoot. And all of us here, I think all of us can say that Ben Simmons is not a top 10 NBA player. So he's had these kind of wacky takes before. But I was watching a segment of him not too long ago where he was talking about Kawhi Leonard and why he thinks that Kawhi Leonard could possibly be ranked number 10. Or at least top 5 if we're able to win this championship. So before I go too far into it, I want you guys just to take a listen to him, take a listen to a soundbite of him just sort of making his argument. So go ahead and listen to that.
Kawhi Leonard is very unique. He doesn't talk. He's got no style. He's great. He's got no shoe deal. I mean, he literally chose the Clippers over the Lakers. He didn't get along with Popovich. They sent him to Canada. His laugh is weird. He's different. He's not like glamorous Michael Jordan or talkative verbal LeBron James or smile every time you saw him Magic Johnson. He's not like our stars. He's much closer to John Stockton, who hated the media. But as of this morning, so I am really in on this thing. So as of this morning, there are he's starting to get into clubs that nobody else in the league is in. Now, the NBA's got 13 guys a team, 30 teams, thousands of players in its history. And I have said, if Kawhi Leonard in 2.5-3 months is holding up a trophy, is holding up the championship trophy, he's a top 10 player in the league all time. I'm going to say it today. He's a top 5 player. He's a top 5 player of all time. Here's why. You tell me it's championships. You tell me this is winning matters. Okay, winning matters. As of this morning, he's in this club. This is a very elite club. In the history of the NBA, you've been a finals winner and MVP with two different teams. Kareem, LeBron, and Kawhi. Now, let's just talk about that for a second. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar is the greatest big man in the history of the league. He's the leading scorer in the history of the league. He created the shot that is, without question, the most unstoppable shot, the skyhook, in the history of the league. You couldn't block it. The second guy is LeBron James, first or second best player ever. The third is Kawhi Leonard. So I would say this is a fairly elite club. Think about how many great players there are. Michael Jordan's not in that list. Magic Johnson's not in that list. Larry Bird, Jerry West, Tim Duncan, all the great players. He wins this year, he's in that club. Okay. So here's another club, the super elite club, where you've been a finals MVP and a defensive player of the year. Not a lot of guys in the NBA are great defenders. There's about 5, 6, 7 guys every year in the league that are really good defenders. Michael, Akeem, and Kawhi Leonard. So that's that club. So you dominate the finals. You're the best player in the biggest games. You're also the best defensive player in the year. That, by the way, wasn't that always the thing with Jordan? You needed a stop. You needed a shot. That was Michael. But we're not done. Now we're going to go to the VIP Elite GOAT Club, where you've been the best player in the finals, MVP, a defensive player of the year, and you've been an MVP in the All-Star game, which is the world's best basketball players, and you're the best one there. Michael and Kawhi. Bruh, how many more clubs you want? How many more clubs you got to be in? You notice who's in these clubs? The 10, 12 best, all the guys he's in the clubs with. Michael, Kareem, LeBron, Hakeem. Those are all top 10, top 12 players. How many more clubs you want? Now, people get into this. Well, Nick Wright yesterday, it was very sad, yelled at me. He doesn't score enough points. Hey, Colin, the scoring days. Nick Wright yesterday.
Do you know where Kawhi Leonard ranks in NBA history and points? I'll answer it for you. You don't, because no one does, because the rankings only go through 250, and he ain't in the top 250, Colin. I got three names for you. Wesley Matthews, Marvin Williams, and Jeff Teague. Those three all-time greats have all scored more points in their career than Kawhi.
Well, so scoring now is the barometer. Do you know the top 15 all-time scoring list in the NBA includes Elvin Hayes, Moses Malone, Dominique Wilkins, and Paul Pierce? So it's scoring now that matters. By the way, Melo is 17th. And nobody likes Melo. He's 17th. Think about that. There's about 15 guys a roster. Melo's 17th all-time. So scoring is it? Elvin Hayes. I apologize to the Elvin Hayes fan club, but I don't think scoring's that big of a deal. I mean, you got to be able to score. So what I'm saying is, and he's 29 years old, meaning he's on a path to surpass Michael and LeBron. If he wins this year, he's going to have a third title, third team, third finals MVP, all-star MVP, defensive player of the year. There's only one player in the history of the league that has more than three finals MVPs. So there's only one. That's MJ. So he's going to have three of those. If he wins this year, he's one of the five best players in league history. MJ, LeBron, Magic, Kareem, Kawhi. Those are the five best players ever.
Now, in the audio, he's making his case. And he's saying that, listen, I would have never seen something as incredible as this, as a playoff performance. He spoke about the fact how that the Toronto Raptors had never won anything, and he won with them to go play with the Los Angeles Clippers and to be with that team, and for them to win an NBA championship, and they had never won an NBA championship before. How impressive that would be. And for him, that would be all he needs for him to put him in the top five as one of the greatest players. Now, I think in his top five, he has LeBron James, Michael Jordan, Wilt, and I think he has Magic Johnson, if I'm not sure. I don't remember his other player. And then he would have Kawhi Leonard. Now, some of you guys in the comment section have been asking me, hey, Charles, what do you think about that? What do you think about Colin Cowherd's take? Do you agree with him? Do you agree with him that if Kawhi Leonard won this NBA championship, this would make him, one of the greatest players in NBA history, possibly the greatest NBA player in the history of one of the top five greatest players in the history of NBA, of the NBA? Well, let me just say this, okay? For me, no, all right? Because we got to look at some of the greatest players of all time. You have Michael Jordan, LeBron James, Kobe Bryant, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, Magic Johnson. I've already given you five. Then you have Wilt Chamberlain, Bill Russell, Shaquille O'Neal, Larry Bird, Tim Duncan, Hakeem Olajuwon, Charles Barkley, and others. Now, if he's going to make it into Colin Cowherd's top 10 or top 5 or whatever it is, we have to look who we bringing out. Okay, who are we bringing out? So, for example, if Kawhi Leonard were to go, if he were to win this NBA championship and he would go into the top 10 of the greatest NBA players, who are we bringing out? Am I going to put Kawhi ahead of Kobe? Hell no. Sorry, I wouldn't. I mean, I love Kawhi Leonard. He's my favorite basketball player in the world right now. But I'm not putting him ahead of Kobe. Kobe's way more decorated. The guy has five NBA championships, two NBA Finals MVPs, has the second highest scoring output in the history of the NBA, been on 9 all-first defensive teams, led the league in scoring, I believe, 2 times. One of the top 5 in scoring in the history of the NBA. So I'm not putting him ahead of Kobe. That's just me. I'm not putting him ahead of Kobe. Obviously, you're not putting him ahead of MJ. LeBron has had a better career, though. Now, what Kawhi Leonard would have accomplished is quite different from what LeBron James would have accomplished. LeBron has 4 regular season MVP awards. He has a scoring title. He has finals MVP awards, but he doesn't have any defensive player of the year awards. Kawhi Leonard has 2 of those, but LeBron James is leading the league in assists. Kawhi Leonard's never done that, but LeBron has never led the league in steals, and Kawhi Leonard has done that. So for me, if he were to be able to win this championship, and for me, I think if he does, it would be one of the most impressive, career achievements for any NBA player, given the fact that he would have gone back to back with 2 teams that have never won an NBA championship. For me, that would put him in rarefied company. But I don't think he would be in my top 10. Now, I think that I would definitely have him ahead of Stephen Curry, for sure. I would definitely have him ahead of Stephen Curry. And I'll possibly have him ahead of Kevin Durant. Now, the only caveat in that is that Kevin Durant has played for more years. I think Kevin Durant has played for about 11 years or so in the NBA. So he has a longer track record of excellence. Kawhi Leonard, this is his 8th season. So I would need to see more consistent performances from him, more all-NBA teams, more all-defensive teams, for me to really say that this guy, okay, he's really in it. Because these guys that are in the top 10 have a really extensive resume. I mean, I'm not into the whole, you need to have a regular season MVP award for you to be, because that one is highly reliant upon the media. But if you're having finals MVP awards, that's you performing at the highest level in the NBA finals. And you can't be denied that. There's no way you can be denied that. Whereas the media, they can have certain agendas, but they're not going to do something egregious like if Kawhi Leonard has a sensational performance in the NBA playoffs in the finals and they're going to give it to Lou Williams or Montrezl Harrell. I don't think something like that would happen, if you understand what I'm saying. So for me, I think this championship would do wonders for his legacy, but he would need at least another 5-6 years of just having fantastic all-NBA, all-first NBA and all-first defensive teams type performances for me to be able to put him in the top 10. Because if I don't, then I'm shortchanging all the guys in that list, because all of these guys are multiple champ. They've won multiple championships. Kobe has 5. LeBron has 3. MJ has 6. Kareem has 6. Magic has 5. Bird has 3. Shaq has 4. Duncan has 5. So what type of argument am I going to make to remove these guys out of, you know, the top 10? So I don't want to be disingenuous and just start saying things and turn into a fanboy and say, oh, yeah, he's in the... No, I'm not one of those type of fans. So for me, if he wins this championship, it definitely puts him in a unique place in NBA history. And mind you, he would also have 3 finals MVPs. There are very few people that have that. LeBron has 3. I think Kareem has 3. But then nobody has more than 3 except Michael Jordan. Michael Jordan has 6. Another reason why MJ is the greatest player of all time. But if Kawhi Leonard was to have like 4 or 5, you know, finals MVPs on his resume, having 5 finals MVPs is way more impressive than having 5 regular season MVP awards. I'm sorry, because James Harden has a regular season MVP award. Russell Westbrook has won a regular season MVP award. None of these guys have won an NBA championship. And I think a finals MVP award carries way more weight than a regular season MVP award. This is just my opinion, but I believe that a finals, because there you have jewelry, you know. Yeah, you can win a regular season MVP award, but having a finals MVP or multiple, having possibly 4 or 5, then somebody has to move out of that top 5. And if he has at least 10, 12, 14 years of fantastic numbers, then it's possible for him to get in the top 5. That's just my opinion. So what I want to know from you guys is quite simple. What is your take on Colin Cowherd? Do you think that he's going a little bit too far and he's jumping the gun by saying that if Kawhi Leonard wins this NBA championship, he's a top 5 NBA player? Or do you think that you need to see more from him, you know, before you start making that kind of assertion? Whatever you guys think, please leave your thoughts and comments in the comment section below. I really want to know what you guys think about this topic, because it's pretty interesting, and I'm quite surprised to hear Colin Cowherd make such an argument about Kawhi Leonard. It's surprising, and I didn't expect it. And I think the people that came on the show were, you know, taken aback by it. I know Chris Broussard was. Nick Wright, we all know Nick Wright. So if Kawhi Leonard won this NBA championship, he'll say it's a fluke or something happened. So I don't really pay much attention to what Nick Wright says. So Anyway, let me know what you think in the comment section below. Again, if you enjoyed the video, make sure you go ahead and hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, make sure you subscribe because we're trying to get to 10,000 subscribers as soon as possible. And hit the notification bell to be notified whenever we drop our content. Once again, this is Charles here from Dreamers Pro. Wishing you guys an amazing day. Peace.